Welcome to the Old Time Radio Westerns. I'm your host, Andrew Rines, and let's get into this episode. This episode is going to be The Lone Ranger. Original air date is February 24th, 1947, and the title is King Creek Strategy. Let's get into it, and again, thanks for listening.
Fiery horse with the speed of light, a cloud of dust, and a hearty hi-yo, Silver, the Lone Ranger. With his faithful Indian companion, Tonto, the daring and resourceful masked rider of the plains led the fight for law and order in the early western United States. Nowhere in the pages of history can one find a greater champion of justice. Return with us now to those thrilling days of yesteryear. From out of the past come the thundering hoofbeats of the great horse, Silver. The Lone Ranger rides again.
Come on, Silver. Let's go, big fellow. I'm Silver. Hooray!
When Nancy Tuttle heard her father's horse return from town, she hurried to the window. Abner was in the barn for several minutes. When he came toward the house, his step was slow, somewhat dragging. It wasn't the stride of a man who had just concluded a satisfactory deal in cattle. Abner's manner wasn't what Nancy had hoped it would be.
But I shan't let him know I'm disappointed. Oh, hi, Dad. Welcome home.
I thought I'd better stable the horse before I came in.
Sit down. You must be tired. It's a long trip to Barter City.
Yep, I reckon it is.
Tell me about your trip, Dad. Did you sell the cattle?
Yep, it's all sold. The papers are signed.
Oh, Dad, that's wonderful. Then you'll have the cash to pay off all your debts and leave quite a bit extra, won't you?
That's right, Nancy.
Oh, then we can get a lot of the things we need and you'll have no more worries. Oh, Dad, I should think you'd be whooping for joy.
Well,
What's the matter?
I won't get the cash until the cattle is delivered. There's been a lot of cattle stolen in this part of the country, and the buyers are making the men who sell the livestock take all the risks.
Oh, but can't something be done about the thieves?
The lawmen are trying to find them, but the gang is plenty smart.
Then it's one gang.
That's what the sheriff says. He seems to have reason to think it's an outfit known as the Cane Creek Gang.
You deliver the cattle, all right. I'm not a bit worried about that.
Well, I am.
You'll feel better when you've had supper. I'll have it ready in just a minute.
Yeah. Won't be easy to get the cattle to the railroad. I don't have enough cowhands.
Can't Can't you hire some extra men?
Not without cash. They won't take the risk. Oh. They want high pay, too. They know they're likely to be called on to fight the King Creek outfit.
It's too bad that...
It was.
Oh, nothing.
You weren't going to say it's too bad Randy Bates isn't around. Is that what you were thinking?
Well, yes, it is. Did you see or hear anything of him while you were in town?
I saw him.
You did? Oh, what did he say? How does he look?
Well, he promised to come here and give us a hand.
Oh, good.
I wish he wouldn't be so downright foolish about taking a share of this ranch.
Well, he wants to get his own place.
Oh, it's that cussed pride of his.
Perhaps you could find some more men in town.
I talked to a couple of strangers. Tried to hire them, but they weren't interested.
Oh.
Now I wish I hadn't talked to them. For all I know, they might be members of the King Creek gang. If they are, they know that I'm aiming to move some cattle to the railroad.
Dad?
Yeah?
If that cattle was stolen, it would have just about wiped us out, wouldn't it?
We'd be flat.
Well, let's hope it doesn't happen. I'll sure be glad to see Ranny Bates. Mighty glad.
Paul Wagstaff ran the general store in Barter City as well as the restaurant. Tables filled one side of the wide room, and there were shelves well stocked and counters along the other side. Ranny Bates stood at the counter. His purchases made quite a pile.
You're taking all these victuals to Abner Tuttle's place?
That's right, Paul.
I'm glad to hear it. Mighty glad. Fact is, Ranny, I'm glad to see you back around these parts. We missed you. But I reckon I know a girl that's missed you more.
I wish I was sure of that.
Ranny, things haven't been so good with Abner.
No?
I can generally tell how things are going by the victuals a man buys. He's been buying mighty plain grub.
Yeah?
I sure was glad to learn he'd closed a deal for his cattle.
Pa, you know what you do?
Huh?
You talk too doggone much.
Well, I do declare.
It won't help Abner to let the King Creek gang hear he's aiming to run cattle on the railroad.
But everyone knows he's made a deal.
Yeah, you probably helped spread the news. You helped a plenty.
Huh. What do you want me to do? Stand here like a stick in the mud and say nothing? There's members of the King Creek gang in town right now. If they hadn't heard about the cattle deal from me, they'd have learned it from somebody else.
Wait a minute. You say there are members of this gang in town?
Sure.
How do you know?
I sold some victuals to one. In fact, he's eating at a table on the other side right now.
You sure of that?
I'd be willing to bet on it.
How do you know?
Ranny, I've told you about the days I spent in Tencho's.
What's that got to do with the Cane Creek gang?
I can tell when a man's got stain or some other kind of disguise on his face.
Go on.
The man at the front table is showing a face that's not his own. A tall gent with broad shoulders. See him?
Uh-huh.
Here's another thing that makes me suspicious of him. When Abner told me about his deal, there was an Indian standing close enough to hear what Abner said.
Yeah?
The Indian hurried out and met that tall man near the hitch rail. Then the tall man came in and bought a lot of supplies before he sat down to order a meal.
What kind of supplies?
Well, the sort of victuals that men would need if they were camping in the open. Maybe hiding in ambush, waiting for a cattle drive. Like Abner's.
Oh, you forget what I said. You don't talk too much.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to have a few words with that stranger. Mind if I sit here for a minute?
No, not at all.
I just thought I'd let you know that this town's an unhealthy place for strangers.
I didn't come here for my health.
Oh? Just passing through the town, is that it?
Possibly.
And you'll probably be out of here by dark.
Well, my plans aren't definite.
I see. I just thought I'd mention it.
Huh?
Because it gets particular unhealthy after dark for strangers.
Well, thanks.
Just thought I'd mention it.
Now that you have mentioned
it. By the way, have you ever heard of the Cane Creek Gang?
Yes, I've heard of the gang. Why do you ask?
Well, there was a gent here a few weeks ago that was suspected of being a member of that gang.
Oh?
He's been dead for a few weeks. And he was only suspected, mind you. There was no proof against him.
Oh, that's poor justice.
Maybe so. Yeah, but I sure would hate to be in the shoes of a man that's really a member of that cow thieving outfit.
Oh?
Especially if he aimed to do anything about Abner Tuttle's cattle.
You, know Abner Tuttle?
I hope to marry his daughter. If by any chance you just happen to run into any of that gang, you might mention that I'm personally interested in seeing Tuttle's stock left alone.
Very well, Ranny.
Huh? You know my name?
Yeah, I've heard of you.
But how did you know?
I'm a Chevron, Ranny. Now remember what you told me. Adios.
Well, doggone. I don't know what to make of that critter.
Well, Ranny, how'd you make out with the stranger?
Boy, I don't know what to think of him. He seemed to have some sort of secret joke. He acted like he wanted to grin at me.
It was the Lone Ranger who rode away from the store. When the town was behind his great horse, Silver, he slipped a mask over his face and headed for a nearby woods where Tonto was waiting.
Oh, Silver, easy. You got the food, Kemosabe?
Yes, Tonto, it's in my saddlebags. But leave it there and saddle your horse. We're riding.
Oh, what we do?
We're going to try to run down the Cane Creek gang.
You hear about gang?
Yes. Very fine. While I was in town, I talked to Ranny Bates. You know, I like him.
Uh-huh.
He thought I was a member of the Cane Creek gang.
Oh.
I didn't tell him otherwise.
What him do?
He let me know that the Tuttle cattle must be left alone.
What we do now? Where we go?
We'll study the cattle trail between the Tuttle ranch and the railroad.
Oh.
Cane Creek gang is clever. Those crooks don't count on weight of numbers. They depend on cunning.
You say we study cattle trail?
Yes. We'll try to decide where the gang is most likely to attack.
Scout ready now.
Good, then mount up. So go to the Tuttle Ranch and follow the trail from there. Easy, Silverman, big fellow. One, two,
get him up, Scout.
Ranny Bates was in Abner Tuttle's home that evening. While Nancy listened, the two men discussed the cattle drive and the likelihood of attack by the Cane Creek gang. They made plans and marked out the route on a map.
And beyond that, Ranny, we'll have to trust to luck. That's about all we can do.
I sure wish we could get more men to help us.
Well, we can't, so that's that. I wouldn't trust strangers anyhow.
Maybe you're right, Mr. Tuttle. All we can do is be ready to fight.
The trouble is, we probably won't have a chance to fight. I've heard a lot about that gang. They're mighty tricky. They don't fight out in the open.
Dad, maybe you and Ranny are borrowing trouble. Maybe the cattle thieves won't bother you at all.
I wish I could believe that.
What makes you so sure there'll be trouble?
Well, there was a man in town.
What about him?
Paul Wagstaff pointed him out. I'm sure he was a member of the gang nosing around town for information.
Well, Ranny, we'll do our best. That's all we can do. I'm sure grateful to you for throwing in with us.
That's nothing.
Why don't you change your mind and throw in with us for keeps? Reconsider the offer I made.
Take a share of your ranch?
Why not?
I can't afford to pay for it, that's why. I'll find a ranch I can afford.
Thunderation. Who's worrying about being paid?
Oh, you're mighty generous, Mr. Tuttle, but I won't take something I can't pay for.
Yeah, still as stubborn as a mule.
Great day.
Ranny! Hey! My window!
Stop that gunplay!
Out there, I saw him.
You loco!
There he goes!
Ranny, what's the matter with you?
I see him.
Look, there's two of them.
Who are they?
Doggone it all, they got away. That's what comes of firing so fast.
But why'd you fire?
I saw a man at the window.
Well, does that call for gunplay?
It did in this case, Nancy. He must have been one of the Cane Creek gang. He wore a mask.
A mask?
Yeah. Now you can be dead sure we're in for trouble on the cattle trail.
The curtain falls on the first act of our Lone Ranger story. Before the next exciting scenes, please permit us to pause for just a few moments. With Ranny Bates firing at him, the Lone Ranger rode away from the Tuttle Ranch with a firm conviction that the Cane Creek gang would surely make an effort to steal Abner Tuttle's cattle on the way to the railroad. During the next few days, while the cattle was being rounded up, the masked man and Tonto examined the trail between the ranch and the point of loading. And then the roundup was completed.
We're all set, Mr. Tuttle. Cattle's all rounded up.
Good, good. How does the stock look to you, Ranny?
Oh, prime. It's got a plenty of weight.
Do you think it'll lose much weight on the trail to the railroad?
Not if we take it easy, Nancy.
You haven't seen anything further the masked man you shot at, have you?
Not a sign of it.
How soon do you think we can get back here?
Oh, we'll be back inside of a week. Wish us luck, honey.
Oh, I'm riding with you.
Cattle drive like this where we're likely to meet the Cane Creek gang is
no place.
Don't
you think I ride well enough?
Oh, it's not that, honey.
I can handle a gun. You need all the riders you can get. Dad said so.
But look, honey. With you to worry about if trouble comes, which is downright likely.
You needn't worry about me. You just worry about the cattle. Well, are we ready to start?
Now, look here, Nancy. I'll tell you what. We plan to camp for one day in the Devil's Pass, where there's good grazing to give the cattle a chance to keep the weight up.
Well, what about it?
Well, you and your dad wait here and let the rest of us have a one-day start. You two start out tomorrow morning. You can catch up to us.
I don't know.
That sounds like a good idea.
Now, how about it? Will you agree to that?
Very well, but Father and I'll meet you on the trail, and don't you go on without me. Get up there.
Adios.
Why'd you suggest that, Randy?
If the Cane Creek gang is going to attack, it'll be at the Devil's Pass. It's the only place on the trail where they could hit us from ambush.
Yeah, it's a likely place.
If we get by the Devil's Pass, there won't be any danger.
And if there is an attack in Devil's Pass, it'll come before Nancy's in bullet range. That's smart, Randy. Downright smart. Doggone it, I won't be with you either.
That's another good point, Mr.
You'll need all the gun hands you can get, especially if you're fighting in an ambush.
Someone's got to be alive to take care of Nancy.
Well, if you think the crooks will wait in Devil's Pass, don't you feel that's a foolish place to spend time pasturing the cattle?
No, I don't. If they're waiting there, they'll be there. If they're not, it won't matter how much time we spend.
Well, good luck to you, sir.
We'll see you soon, Mr. Tuttle.
Steady, boy.
All set, boys. Let's get started. You wing riders, keep your eyes open and keep the herd in close. Here we go. Get up, boy. Ho!
Far ahead of the Tuttle Ranch, the Lone Ranger and Tonto were waiting in a small camp on the side of a steep hill. The huge rock that studded the hill gave the masked man and his friend concealment. They had been waiting patiently, eating cold food so no campfire would betray their presence. Finally, the vigil was rewarded.
You look between rocks, Kemosabe. See over at entrance a pass.
Cattle.
Ah.
Must be the Tuttle herd. We've seen no sign of the Cane Creek gang.
That's right.
Tonto, we've been over the entire trail. And I don't know of any other place where that pack of outlaws could ambush the cowboys.
Maybe gang attack some other place.
But there is no other place where a small gang could ambush a cattle drive. Can't believe that those outlaws will pass up the Tuttle herd.
The cattle came into the valley in a close, packed mass. There the drive was stopped.
Herd them in a circle, boys. Keep your eyes open on all sides. If we're to be ambushed, this is where it'll come.
Rennie and the other cowboys were pleasantly surprised when the afternoon passed without attack. Their vigilance increased as darkness gathered.
They may move in at night, boys, so be ready for trouble.
As the night advanced without any sign of the Cane Creek gang, the hopes of the men began to rise, but no one went off guard. There was no attack, and the next morning, as Rennie Bates led the drive at a slow pace, he couldn't rid himself of the feeling that the Cane Creek gang would surely strike in some unexpected way. Far behind the last of the cattle, the Lone Ranger and Tonto rode in the same direction.
We'll keep as far back as we can, Tonto, without losing sight of the herd.
All we see is clouded dust.
We're close enough to hear any gunfire.
Oh, that's right. All open country to railroad.
Yes, I know.
You still think Cane Creek gang make attack?
I'll tell you what I think, Tonto. The gang will try some means to get control of that cattle. Whatever it is, it will be unexpected.
That's right.
Otto, look behind us.
Horse come this way.
Quickly, get to the side of the trail. Come on, Silver.
This way, Scout. This way, Father.
Steady, boy. Ho, Silver. Ho, easy, steady. We'll wait here and see who those riders are.
One looked like girl.
You're right. Nancy Tuttle. Her father's with her. Come on, we'll ride toward them. Come on, Silver.
Get him up, Scout.
Up there.
What this
hand here? Hold the tunnel, Hosilver.
He's mad.
Don't draw.
Where are you?
That's it. Just leave your gun and leather. I simply want to talk to you. You see, I'm the man Rennie fired at the other night.
Then you were at the window.
Now, please forgive me for that. I had to know something about your plans. Rennie probably thought I was one of the Cane Creek gang, but I'm not.
Then who are you?
Otto and I have been watching your drive. We hope to catch the cattle thieves if they attack your men.
But the cattle's beyond the pass, isn't it?
Yes.
Well, then there probably won't be an attack.
There is. I don't want Bates to fire on us when we try to help. Here, give him this bullet.
The bullet?
It's made of silver. It may mean something to Rennie, especially if you tell him my horse is called Silver.
A silver bullet. Tonto, the mask. Great Scott. Whether this means anything to Rennie or not, it means a plenty to me.
Well, if you hurry, you'll overtake your herd in a few minutes. Come on, Tonto.
Be ready.
Come on, Silver.
Get him up, Scout.
Much to Rennie Bates' surprise, the Tuttle cattle reached town safely, where the empty cattle cars were waiting, with no sign of the Cane Creek gang. The loading got underway at once. Car after car was filled with the prime cattle. The last of the steers was in the car and the door was closed. The engine backed along a spur track to pick up the cars.
There comes the engine, boss. You make the coupling in a second.
What's the matter with that engine?
Hey, tell him to watch out. He's going to hit the coupling too hard.
Oh. Hey, watch yourself.
Tell that engineer to be careful. You'll hurt those critters in the car.
Look, he's missed the coupling.
Slow down. Don't back up so fast. Be careful next time.
Apart from all the other men who watched the engineer's efforts and wondered about them, were the Lone Ranger and Tonto.
Tonto, I wonder why one of the trainmen doesn't signal from the platform.
Well, that engineer no good.
He's going to try it again.
Him make coupling that time.
Yes, at last. I never saw such a bungling engineer. He acts as if he never handled an engine before. He think... Otto.
What matter?
Maybe that's the answer. Maybe that man never did run an engine before. I want to see who's in that cab. Come on, Silver.
Get him up, Scout.
The masked man raced ahead with Tonto close behind. He came abreast the engine cab and saw not one but four men inside. Men who wore no trainman's overalls.
Hold, Silver. Hold, fella.
Look at them, Tonto. There's the answer. Come on, Silver.
Get him up, Scout.
Abner, his daughter, Ranny Bates, and all the others felt elated when they saw the train get underway. But then they saw the masked man and the Indian rushing toward them at top speed.
Oh, Silver, hold on.
That's him.
The man I fired at.
Bates, Tuttle, get after that train. All of you, hit your saddles. Your cattle's being stolen. Follow me. Come on, Silver.
Come on, Silver.
Lone Ranger took the lead, racing alongside the chugging train with Tonto close behind and the Tuttle cowhands following. He came up to the engine cab.
Up the train!
Get away from here!
Clear out of it, drop you!
Not with that gun!
Hey, boys! Open up by that mess!
You haven't enough speed to get away!
Ranny and the other men raced up to the engine. Their guns joined those of the Lone Ranger. The men inside the engine dropped their guns and threw up their hands.
That's not enough. Close the throttle. Put on the brake. Be quick.
Use these sense, boys. I don't want to get shot.
There, Ranny, is your Cane Creek gang.
Four men. Well, of all the doggone things...
Ranny, what happened?
Look in that engine, Nancy. The train crew's been hogtied on the floor.
And who are these?
The Cane Creek gang, boss. I knew we'd meet them sooner or later.
All right, you got us.
Just four of you, huh?
Just four of us. And I bet we made more cattle hauls than any gang with three times our number.
Well, you've made your last haul. Your prisoners, Bates.
Mine?
Certainly. Tuttle put you in charge of this drive, didn't he?
Yeah, but that
and
doesn't...
And you got the rewards.
Rewards? Oh, Ranny, do you hear that? Yeah,
but what about you? You're the one that's deserving...
I won't be around to collect the rewards. See, Tuttle and I have to leave here. Any there, Silver. And besides, Ranny, I don't need the cash because I'm not interested in buying half interest in the Tuttle Ranch.
Buy half interest?
Yeah, you hear that, Ranny? Cash to pay for what you wouldn't let me give you.
Oh, well, then I... Nancy, do you realize what this means?
Yeah, of course he does. And so does that Lone Ranger.
Come on, Tonto. Come on, Silver!
Doggone. To think that the man I saw looking in your window was the Lone Ranger.
That's right, son.
I wonder who it was I talked to in Paul Wagstaff's place. I reckon I must have scared that hombre away.
Thank you.
you have just heard is a copyrighted feature of the Lone Ranger Incorporated.
This has been a presentation of OTRWesterns.com, and we hope you enjoyed. Please take some time to like and rate our shows in your favorite podcast application. Follow us on Facebook by going to OTRWesterns.com/Facebook. Subscribe to our YouTube channel by going to OTRWesterns.com/YouTube. And send us an email, podcast@OTRWesterns.com. You can call and leave us a voicemail, 707-986-8739. This episode is copyright under the Attribution Non-Commercial Share-Alike copyright. For more information, go to otrwesterns.com/copyright. Have a great day, and thanks for listening.